And I'm back at Disney World. I'm also back at the Spew of the Mickey Power Pole, where Adam the Woo frequently started a video where he went to the Disney parks. It's Christmas Day. Not much traffic on I-4 South right now, but the thoroughfare has been backed up until the Champions Gate exit about 4 miles south here. Anyone know what's been going on at Champions Gate? Guess it's a popular place. Anyway, today I'm heading to Epcot for Christmas Day, taking advantage of the lower crowds by getting into the park right at rope drop. I'll be riding some rides, and also going to check out the Festival of the Holidays, special food being served, as well as special holiday drinks, which I won't be having. It's a beautiful Christmas Day. Let's go! Right at the start, I'm in boarding group 8, yes, 8, for Remy's Ratatouille Adventure. So we fast walk to the France Pavilion. Made it to the new Ratatouille section, and they are already boarding my group. I hope my wait inside won't be too bad. Last month we waited about an hour after entering the virtual queue line. About a 20 minute wait, not bad at all. I still had to wait behind people paying $11 in the lightning lane.
Chef Remy is waiting for you. This way. Oh, here they are, Remy. Les invités pour le dîner.
Yes, what to prepare? Pour le repas idéal. Pourquoi pas? No. A simple omelet? Too simple.
What?
Mais oui, that's it.
Yeah.
call it a sea ticket ride. And look at the virtual queue line now. It's about 45 minutes wait now. Now I'm heading for the Norway Pavilion, and I'm going on the Frozen ride. I haven't been on this ride since it opened up a few years ago. I did get Genie Plus today, so I'm avoiding the long wait, but...
Sammy! It broke down. We're gonna have to leave. We're so close.
They evacuated the ride just a few steps before we were about to go on the ride. But they did give us a special fast pass, so now we can get on it later. Looks like it's called an experience redemption, and I can return anytime today. But now my lightning wing window is open for Soarin'. There sure are a lot of walls here. I see why they call this park Walcott. On this warm day, the walls also radiate a lot of heat. Made the long walk over to the land. I love the Soarin' ride. I also love not waiting 60 minutes in a standby line. I like the Soarin' queue line at Epcot better than the airport hangar type line at California Adventure. The ride is basically the same on both coasts. And now, here's David Putty.
Hello and welcome to Soarin'. My name is Patrick and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll begin boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information. When the doors to your flight open, please take a seat. Store all carry-on items in the underseat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and of course, these little beauties. That's work, pal.
I'm seated all the way on the left, so much of the video on the screen will be distorted. In the same building as the Living with the Land ride, it's basically a 15-minute relaxing boat ride. They now stress that people should stay in the boat after someone got off the boat during the vegetable farm part of the ride.
In our search for more efficient ways to grow food, we often fail to realize the impact of our methods.
From Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture illuminate the wondrous gifts we receive from the land. Join us as we ring in the most bountiful time of the year.
When you think of holidays, you might not think of fish, but seafood is an essential part of many festive meals.
In parts of southern Italy, family and friends gather once a year to celebrate Lacagione with a 7-course seafood dinner. Tilapia, bass, and shrimp, like the ones raised here, using our sustainable water systems, make up just some of the dishes served during this grand meal. Today, in the United States, the tradition is known as the Feast of the Seven Fishes. Northern Europe, where fresh fruit is rare in winter, they're much harder to find, making them an extra special stocking stuffer. Nutmeg for its signature taste. Other spices, like ginger and vanilla, add flavor to a variety of holiday cookies, cakes, and other delights.
Now back in World Showcase, I'm going to try a couple of dishes near the Canada Pavilion. The sear scallops and the beef bourguignon.
Now we're going to try the beef something. It starts with a B, we don't know how to pronounce it. Let's see. Oh, that looks... I think there's some mashed potatoes in here too. Oh, that's really good. Next we're gonna try the scallops. I don't think I've ever had scallops before. How am I gonna do this? Get some of everything. Tastes like scallops. There you go.
Nearby at the refreshment port, they have this turkey poutine with turkey, gravy, onion crisp, and cranberry sauce.
Now we're trying the turkey poutine without cheese curds, so it's not actually poutine. It's really hot, so it's like burning my hand. I'm trying to figure out how to do this. They're really good. They should just call it like the Thanksgiving poutine. That's what they should do. Because it's got the gravy, the turkey, and the cranberry sauce, and the crunchy onions.
Now I'm here at the Mexico Pavilion at the Las Posadas booth where we got a barbacoa beef tamale and dulce de leche churros. We also got some tart and tangy cheese from Joffrey's.
So first I'm going to try the dulce de leche churro if I can get it off the plate. It's definitely like crunchier and it's got more of the cinnamon sugar on it than the like normal churros do. I think that feels better than the normal churro. So now we got the tamale. I think it's already unwrapped, is it? I think so. Yeah, it's already unwrapped. Good choice, Dad. He was gonna get the tostada instead of this, but this is really good.
I'm now at Test Track. Probably my favorite ride of all in Walt Disney World. I think it's the fastest ride at 65 miles per hour. I'll design my test vehicle and then take it out for a spin.
Responsiveness test.
That was really fun. Now I need to hydrate myself at Club Cool. My favorite is the raspberry soda. Getting late into the afternoon, and the crowds are definitely starting to fill up the park. The Mexico area is always busy, with a few restaurants and the dark ride inside the pyramid. The queue for this ride is so confusing. You line up on the right, then you have to go to the left and line up again. The artwork in this lobby is the bridal couple. The ancestors of the family that made this sculpture have been making this type of artwork for 300 years. This ride opened on Epcot's first day on October 1st, 1982. In 2007, the ride was slightly changed to add the Three Caballeros, Donald Duck, Jose Carioca, and Panchito Pistoles. People say there's a hidden Mickey either on the pyramid or the volcano, but I don't see it.
There's a little hut over there.
Now back in Ori, my second attempt to ride the Frozen Ever After ride. Here's my vote. Looks like it's gonna happen this time.
Oh, put it together, it just makes sense. Ra-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Now I'm at the refreshment outpost, gonna try out this coconut pineapple cake with Dole Whip on top.
So now we got a coconut pineapple cake with Dole Whip on top. I'm gonna try the cake by its... No, not your cake, my cake. Come on. Our table's a little wobbly. The cake's really good by itself, let's see. I love Dole Whip. Suction cup Dole Whip, apparently. Next time at the Bavaria Holiday Kitchen, I have this cheese fondue and a bread bowl and some vegetables. So I got the fondue. Move some of the vegetables over. Oh, that looks good. Oh, what happened? Oh, there's not much in here. I was like, it's very tough right here.
Oh my god, we love
that's
the
awesome.
These are like Kevin Morning.
Yeah.
That's really good.
I was just there to keep.
I would have thought it was just like melted like cheddar cheese in there.
All the way down to Key West, go to Duval Street. Watch the sunset. Beautiful. Okay. You gotta go all the way because Isla Morada.
Yeah.
Right. It's like, man, there's not that much.
Key West.
Well, I just went to West Circuit to
see. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, you gotta go all the way down. Right.
So first we got the pork schnitzel with what is it? Spätzle. Not what you said earlier. They were out of forks, so let's see how well this goes. Yeah, hold on.
Yeah.
The schnitzel itself doesn't really have a lot of flavor. Let's see. I now have a couple of other dishes from the Tuscany Holiday Kitchen. First is this lobster ravioli in an Alfredo or scampi sauce. I also have mozzarella crocanti, which is crispy ravioli filled with mozzarella and topped with pomodoro sauce. So I got some ravioli. It was supposed to be shrimp, but today apparently is lobster. So. Definitely lobster colored. I don't know what's so wet on the outside.
It's an Alfredo.
It's a very... Does this look like Alfredo to anyone?
Everything.
Eh. So now we got some fried ravioli and what's called a pomodoro sauce. I don't know what that is.
So I said after this.
They're playing Carol of the Bells back there. I got really excited. It's just kind of like they just fried the ravioli that you get at Olive Garden. That's what it tastes like.
I need to like
made my way to the American Pavilion. Going to have the turkey dinner. It's basically the same thing as the turkey poutine I had earlier, but this has stuffing and green beans. I also have this gingerbread pumpkin cheesecake. I heard it was really good and I'm looking forward to it.
So we're here at the American Pavilion next to the tree. There's gonna be some nice music going on in the background because we do have the candlelight processional tonight. I believe the guest narrator is Stephen Curtis Chapman. And we got some of the turkey here. I believe this is hopefully the same turkey that was on the poutine earlier. It looks tasty. I don't know why I grabbed the part that didn't have anything on it. It's the same turkey and it's still good. So next is the pumpkin gingerbread cheesecake.
Yum 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 yum.
It may be orange, but I don't taste any pumpkin at all. Maybe if I eat a pumpkin seed.
Is it good?
It's good, yeah, but like, I don't taste any. I don't taste any like pumpkin or anything.
This tree in front of the American Adventure building is very beautiful. The sun is just about set and the lights have come on. Now near the Japan Pavilion, at the Shiwasu Holiday Kitchen, I got the New Year celebration soba with noodles, a fish cake, and shrimp tempura and a hot dashi soup.
So now we've got the celebration soba. Why is it all stuck together? Hold on.
Thanks for visiting us today. For the safety and health of everyone, masks fully covering your mouth and nose are required when indoors. Wash your hands often and cover your mouth and nose when coughing or sneezing. Thank you for your cooperation.
I know it's not like the miso base, but it tastes like the miso base that I get whenever I get ramen. Where's that fish cake? Let's see. Oh, it's hiding behind my fork. I love the fish cakes. I literally ask for extra fish cake every time I get ramen.
Next at the Lahaim Holiday Kitchen. I have this smoked salmon potato latke. I'm just going to take a bite. I'm not too big of a salmon fan.
So now we've got the smoked salmon latke. Come here. I'm not the biggest fan of salmon, but this is actually pretty good. I think Maddie, who I do the Fantastic Food Fanatics with, would love this, because anytime we go to like Longhorn, she always orders the salmon. She loves it.
My last dish of the evening is the Bûche de Noël, or a chocolate Christmas log found near the France Pavilion. It has white chocolate mousse, raspberry cream, and covered with chocolate fudge.
So now we've got the Bûche de Noël. It's like basically chocolate and raspberry. It has some tart raspberry. That's really good. I remember I made like a I think it's called like a Yule log, is that what it was called? Yeah. With my friend Matthew 1 year. This tastes like that. But I don't remember if the other one had raspberry in it or not.
Now I'm going to do a quick run through three more rides before I have to leave for the evening, starting with Journey to Imagination with Figment.
Sound, your ears are hearing, 1,000 thoughts can start appearing.
Good times roll!
This is a great idea to add the LED lights to Spaceship Earth. Next, I'm going to the Seas with Nemo and Friends.
Is he orange with white stripes and looks kind of like you, only smaller?
Yes, have you seen him?
Seen who?
Jellyfish!
Right!
Okay, now I'm thinking of something kind of
moving.
That's jellyfish!
You're good.
And I'm thinking...
Nemo! Why did you come back from the bottom? Oh!
more on the beautiful little.
Finally, I'm going to thank the Phoenicians and Spaceship Earth.
For your safety, remain seated at all times. During your slow-moving journey,
and that's it. I should mention I only had one or two bites of each dish. I shared all the food dishes with my parents. Each dish was about $5 to $9 a piece, so we probably spent about $100 on all the food, plus some drinks as well. We did the pro tip of getting all our drinks at Joffrey's since we have a 20% pass holder discount. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye! Speaking of annual passes, look what I got in the mail today.